Whether you're trying to set a countdown for an upcoming stream, or if you're just looking for a quick way to boost engagement effectively, you've come to the right place because there's zero download required. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is go down to sources and add a source. You're going to choose text GDI plus, and I'm going to go ahead and name that timer just to keep it simple. And what you're going to do here is change the font to be whatever you'd like it to be, change the size. You can also add a gradient if you want, and you can go back and tweak it later. But the first thing that you want is to just have that timer set up. The next thing that we're going to do is at the top of OBS Studio, you'll want to go over to Tools, go down to Scripts, and it'll bring up this window. So what you're going to do here is click the plus, and it'll automatically open the Scripts folder in OBS. And these all come pre-downloaded. So the one that we are going to be using today is countdown.lua. Go ahead and click that. And then what you'll do is you'll choose which text source for it to inject its code into. Go ahead and choose the timer one that we set up. And what you can do is you can tweak your timer as much as you want. Now, if you are like me and you're not a fan of these extra zeros because you don't plan on having an hour long countdown, bring that window back up and go to edit script. Now, don't worry, we're not going to do anything crazy. Just open it in Notepad and you'll see this entire list of stuff that might not make sense to you. But you're going to look for this line right here. And what you'll do is starting from the percent to the colon, hit backspace. And from the H to the space in front of minutes, hit backspace. And then you can go ahead and save that file. You'll notice that it won't let you save there unless you have administrative permissions, but you can just go ahead and save it into your documents folder. Just make sure that the end is .lua, no txt. I like to pull up a second files explorer here, and this is the file path for where the scripts are located for OBS. And I just went ahead and hit enter, and you'll see that we've got the list here as well. So I'm just going to simply drag it in, and it's going to tell you that you need administrator access. So as long as you have that, you should be good. We'll just go ahead and delete the original one and rename the one that we just made, if it still has the txt at the end. After that, all you have to do is just reload the script and you will have your dedicated minute timer. Hopefully you guys found this video easy to follow. And if you have any questions, just drop the question below in the comments. Make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I hope to help you guys out with some more easy OBS, short, sweet, to the point stuff. All right, take it easy, guys.